next two throughout the night. But right now, it's time to go to a DJ who's going to ask you to put those sixes up, baby. It's Inner Demonz.
Indifferent. we split.
You're indifferent. Christonics.
Gobble, gobble up, put my money on top, fight in the belly, fuck all the
sexy.
Yeah.
hardcore misfits pulling up the clock quick. It's about to go down and it's getting heavy. Cause everybody got machetes on this sharp and ready. Clay, clay, boom, you blowing out your fucking brains.
This technology would be the Genesis Project.
Demonz. invitation might be just what this sanctuary needs. You stand now at the precipice of the void. I am reminded of another listener, a protege I knew long ago. My time saw the assassination of an emperor as well. Alas, the Dark Brotherhood did not have the honor of that kill.
Fun. Yes, you guys should see what it's like here. This amazing crew at Social Sanctuary. They are top of the line. So shout out to them for having us here. Hope you guys have enjoyed everything they've been putting out, especially the EDM Maniac stuff. So we are going to be joined right now by Inner Demonz, who just did his thing right there. So guys, make sure you send us your questions all throughout the nights in the comments section as well. We're going to get to those and we're going to keep this show moving. What's up, ID?
How's it going?
How has quarantine affected your career lately? I you know, you're used to masks. That's good.
Can you hear me?
We can.
Okay, cool. You know, I think for most DJs right now, gigs are somewhat non-existent, except for the live stream. But I'm very, very thankful for, you know, Social Sanctuary and
yeah, so
EDM Maniac.
All the live streams, what has the community been like? Are you making a schedule for yourself? Is everyone trying to get on as many as possible? Are you just waiting to be called? As a DJ, what's been the live stream lifestyle like?
It's, you know, it's obviously different than playing live. You know, you don't have a live audience to feed off of, but the comments and the viewers, you know they're feeling it, so it's cool. Working on a lot more music, of course. I started live streaming a little bit. My producing, so you know, it opens up new opportunities.
Now, while just on the topic of live streams, this venue is not like playing in your bedroom. So how does it impact you being here in a venue like this?
Oh dude, I'm stoked. Like when I, you know, got booked here, I was like, this is freaking sick. The huge screen in the back and just everything, the whole experience, it's as close as you can get.
100%. Yeah. Now, we might have some new hardstyle fans watching, mostly probably dedicated, but can you kind of express what the hardstyle community is all about?
I mean, it's obviously about connection and love and respect. It's definitely about energy. We love hard drops, a lot of bass, so, you know.
What do you find everyone sort of has in common, whether it's fans or fellow DJs that make this style of music? What's that thread that binds everybody?
I mean, everything I just said, like respect. Everyone's so, you know, supportive and respectful. Everybody gets really excited, which that's the energy level. Like, you can feel the excitement from the fans. So that's really what keeps me going.
Right on. Let's talk personal life. What's your deal? Like, do you have a girlfriend, boyfriend? Do you live alone? What's the deal?
I mean, I came from the lower fourth dimension and I shapeshifted here.
I believe it.
I did snag myself a fiance. She's sitting right over there.
Oh, God bless.
So she comes back and forth with me through dimensions sometimes, you know.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's tight.
Apparently, the reality we're living in is just a expression of like the eight dimensions played out. I don't know. I saw a TikTok yesterday.
It's a simulation, bro.
Yeah. real talk. So do you feel a certain connection to, you know, the higher power or the universe through your music at all?
Absolutely. That's why I do this. You know, like, music brings that out, and you feel that, especially when you're playing live. You feel that with everybody, so that's the thing.
All right, amazing. Well, you know, we keep it here. We're going to keep talking to Inner Demonz. We got Junkie Kid coming up, Misfits later, and Lady Faith. We're going to keep it here. Give you guys the next clue, though. We have three words. You need three words. You have two. Don't. Second word that you're gonna need for those free tickets is the word stop. So don't stop is the first two words. Later on today, we're gonna give you that third word. So again, you could sign up to win two free tickets to any music festival in the United States when we are back to work. But that's not all, because we got more announcements, ID. We got more announcements. EDM Drive-In is gonna be coming back. That is a brand new announcement. Now, we don't know where or when, so you gotta stay tuned to EDM underscore Maniac for all that stuff, but EDM Drive-In is gonna be back. And don't forget to go to shop.edmmaniac.com for all your exclusive merch here. Any other hobbies for you? Any spending time the past few months? Or you and your fiance, what's some things you guys have adopted that might be new that you weren't doing previously?
Well, I mean, to answer the reverse of that question, we miss going to movies.
especially today, it was so hot.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be cool? Anyway.
Perfect movie day, but we watch movies at home now, of course. Surprisingly, I don't know if this is popular at all, but I play chess. I like playing chess.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, chess is such an amazing game. What's some things about chess that like people don't really know, but when you start playing it, you really understand?
I mean, it's really just the experience. Like, no one can tell you how to play chess well other than just play and practice. So it's the same as any other skill, you know. And I definitely apply my chess playing to music. You know, it's all strategic.
It's like the game of life. This ain't checkers. This chess, baby.
Listen to him.
Chess,
he knows.
Ain't checkers. Long strategy. Now, talking to movies, Palm Springs on Hulu. Very good. You see that yet?
Nah.
The Andy Samberg movie?
Okay.
Check it out. It is literally, you'll watch it and be like, that's a movie.
I'm down.
Haven't seen a movie like this in a while. It was the, talking about movies and movie business now, it was the highest single purchase price in Sundance history.
Wow.
$22 million for it to be a Hulu exclusive.
Holy.
And it's really great. So more and more streaming and stuff. Now, the way that, you know, the industry's been transformed in movies, but also in music now. So from a career point of view with live streaming and just streaming in general, is there any sort of like priorities that you shifted to, you know, adjust to the new lifestyle?
I mean, visuals and your social media is a lot more important now. I mean, it's always been important, but now it's like that's the focal point. So my brand has always been about like, I'm supposed to be like a musical horror movie. So I'm big on that, you know, visuals and being scary, and I'm looking for more Photoshop.
Yeah, well, have you developed any sort of skill set in like the film scoring or working on, you know, getting your music integrated in other projects?
I've scored a couple small indie films, and I definitely incorporate that in my production. I mean, yeah, I love film scoring.
Really cool. I mean, what month are we in? Oh, Halloween is coming up. Is that like your big month?
That's my month. It's right there.
Yeah, right on. Well, I'm sure there's a lot we could learn from you. What is coming up from you in the next few months?
I got new tracks coming. I actually have a collab with Maxis, so we're going to drop something soon. I just played one of my new tracks, Dr. Sleep, which is themed off the Dr. Sleep movie. Just a bunch of productions.
And how does collabs work generally? Do you make 75% of the song and you ask your partner to finish it? Are you like in the studio together from day one? What's the usual workout?
It could go any of those ways. Maxis and I like hang out sometimes. So we, you know, we had a lot of back and forth about it online, in person, all of the above.
That's fantastic. Any new things that you've seen online, like DJs playing in like a mountain range or like on a farm? Any cool new weird things you're gonna try to do while live events are still kind of on hiatus?
Nothing crazy like that I've seen. I mean, just the visual effects are getting next level, like these, you know, VR sets and
absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I know Snapchat has this cool VR, AR set for people.
Things are just getting trippier and trippier.
And my friend was showing me that on these TV shows, this is an amazing set that I would not change for anything, but they have full green screen sets that like kind of recreate this. But at the end of the day, you can't recreate this. So thank you, Inner Demonz. Appreciate
you
hanging out. We're going to check you out online and follow along with what you have going on. But really important, you guys, in the comment section, what's been your favorite thing to do during quarantine so far? Is it doing nothing? Because doing nothing really is underrated. Like, doing nothing is low-key, like, the best, as long as you can earn doing nothing.
Yes.
And, but what are your opinions about people partying? I mean, we're trying to get the party going in the comments section right now. And don't forget, if two of you want to win those two free tickets, the first keyword.